Hi guys, I'm here to react to the boys' Watch It music video. But before that, let me talk about the concept this time. Alright, the concept this time, I saw from the concept film and the concept photos, they are having a mysterious vibe and having different side of them in each photo shoot, such as the fake version where they are being scanned by the security electronic device and the other two versions, one they are in front of the pink background, and the other they are in the remote area with big black trucks and remote building. Alright, so with that kind of concept, I'm really curious what the song will be like. Now, after talking about the concept film and the concept photos, let me talk about the track clip ranking. First up, I have Crying and Laughter. Number two, I have Bad Luck. Number three, I have Watch It. Number four, I have Escape. Number five, I have Rat in the Trap. And number six, I have Honey. Alright, with this ranking for the track clip, I'm curious to see how they will change after my first listen. Alright, without further ado, let me jump right into the music video reaction for Watch It in 3, 2, 1. Alright, cat scene. Oh, trucks. Wings Express. Yonghun starting the song. Well, they're having duo dance now. Wow, their deep voice. Wow. Their lower register. Yes, the pre-chorus. Wow. It's nice, the background behind you. The flowery. Onion. Oh, the chorus. Oh, the lighting changed from white to dark blue. Wow. Wow, chill and short chorus vibe. Wow, the track. Yes, the shuffling. Whoa, the sparks. Hey, the delivery. Wow, they're in the warehouse with the bicycles. The wink. Oh, caution too hot to handle. Oh, trophies. Oh, having fun in the truck, in the cart. Wow, they dance in between the warehouse. Wow, they changed the choreo. Wow, the lyrics for the chorus, short and sweet. Wow, the high note. The body wave. The butterflies. Where they leaning to? Oh my god, explosion. Wow, the notes. Wow. The lighting action. Wow, with all the backup dancers at the back. Wow. Whoa, the ending is like mixture of colors. All right, let me talk about the song. Okay, let me recall. Okay. The visuals of the music video, okay, it's a lot of things happening. Oh my god, I'm trying to recall from the first second to the end. Okay, the first verse, wow, it started off strong with the lower register voice from Yonghoon. Oh my god, then like one by one, they take up the lines, and then still keeping very closely to the keeping their voice very closely to the lower register, and then goes to the pre-chorus. Wow, the pre-chorus is very beautiful. Oh my god, I love how they play with their voices and how they play with the instrumentals. Wow, I like how the pre-chorus is being shown really, really nicely and sound really, really melodic. And then here comes the anti-drop kind of chorus where it's short and sweet lyrics, and the instrumental totally change, and the way they sing the lyrics also totally change. It's not that melodic, it's more of very heart punching and like very mysterious kind of voice. The lyrics also quite mysterious. I don't really know what they sing about because I never turn on the subtitles. I know in the chorus they sing about the speed change. I forgot the exact lyrics, yeah, but it's okay, let me don't talk about the meaning of the lyrics because I don't know the meaning and the translation. So let me just focus on the musical feeling wise. Okay, then here comes the second verse. Ooh, they got more lower register shown by other members. Wow, like each of them, they took turns to show the lower register. It's really nice. I like they make use of the opportunity to show the lower register, and then the second verse, after second verse, I'm not sure if there's a pre-chorus. Then I remember the second chorus, they changed up the choreography. Wow, then the location also changed to warehouse setting instead of the first chorus where they are in like a cafe or like the entrance or like another shop kind of feel. The second chorus is a warehouse, and then the bridge hits. Wow, all the high note come, and like the formation also really, really nice. They have a V shape, I think. Then after the bridge ends, the notes, wow, it's a lot of changing of notes of the high notes. So it's not just straight high, there's a few layers of the high note. And then the last chorus, yeah, the lighting performance, like the light performance being shown in the background with them dancing. Wow, it's like really, really lighting fest. Yeah, and with that, it closes the song. All right, so with that in mind, I think I will give it first listen, I will give it 7. Yeah, because it's a song that I enjoy, especially the pre-chorus and the verses, because it shows their lower register. Only the chorus I need some time to warm up, so I think 7 is a good mark lah. The other 3 marks is because I still need some time to warm up to the chorus. Alright, the outfit is corresponding to their concept photos, so that one I did not see any changes made. Yeah, and then yeah, so I think 7 mark is what I feel for the first listen. All right, without further ado, let me find the B-side tracks of this part 2, Sixth Sense comeback. Okay, the second track of the release is called Rat in the Trap, featuring another the boys special unit vocal members, if I'm not wrong. All right, in 3, 2, 1. Okay, is giving groovy vibes. Alright, so far is giving the track clip lyrics. Okay, here goes. Pre-chorus. Oh, chorus. Oh. The way they sing it is creepy, kind of voice tone. Wow, there's some robot filter. Okay, second verse. Wow, they're carrying on. Wow. Wow, there's some background vocals at the back by another member. Wow, layering of their voices. The same instrumental of the pre-chorus. Okay, here goes the creepy voice tone. It's like creepy slash groovy. The bridge. Okay, all slow down. Oh, there's some knocking of the glass, I think. There's no way out. Yes, Jacob. All right, the last chorus. Okay, they sing with the same creepy slash groovy voice type. More instrumental at the end. Okay, let me rate the song. I shall give it first listen. Okay, I shall give it 4 because it's in general it's carrying the creepy slash groovy vibe, which is not my type of music. That's why I give it only a 4. Yeah. Without further ado, let me go on to track number 3, Honey, in 3, 2, 1. The unit of Sanu and Eric. Alright, this is the track clip lyrics. Oh, this is not in the track clip. Oh, hip rock, oh, wow. Rap heavy, huh? Okay, now it's like slowed down a lot. Oh, now they focus on the R&B side. Wow. Wow, they are very on beat. With the beat from the instrumental. Okay, this is the track clip part. All right, back to the R&B side. Enjoying this R&B side. The voices! Wow! Alright, the very on-beat kind of chorus. Very bouncy kind of chorus. Just want to make me just keep on bouncing. Here comes the ticking ticking instrumental. Plus the on beat, bouncy kind of instrumental. Alright, that's the end of Honey. Alright, let me give you a score. At first listen, I'll give it I think I'll give it 4, same as Red in the Trap, because the rap part is not my kind of music, only the R&B part. So 4 over 10 for first listen. Alright, without further ado, let me go on to the fourth track called Bad Luck in 3, 2, 1. Wow, the instrumental. Yes! It reminds me of Salty Vibes. The song Salty. The vibe. The club kind of vibe. Oh, they are singing quite fast with the beat. Also going quite fast now. I'm so excited to hear. Alright, this part is the track clip. The low tone, low register. This part I like it more. R&B. Very melodic. For you. Alright, right. Oh, hold the rap. Go on. Wow, they go on, still go on. Whoa. Wow, low register. Wow, more rap. Rap verse. Alright, here comes the second pre-chorus. The bridge. Oh, the brassy vocals from Neil. Wow. Just let it flow, the high note. All right, last chorus. 然后 the ending part， 然后 super fast， 哇哇哇哇 ，just keep on going， 哇哇哇哇。Whoa, just high note at the end. All right, this song, wow, it contains creepy vibe in the pre-chorus. So I will give it 7, same as Watch It, because the verses, all that, the bridge, all that, what I really like, just the creepy vibe, I don't really like. So the score is same as Watch It, because Watch It is the chorus I don't really like, the verses and the bridge I really like, so it's not entire song a pass. Yeah, but the chorus is like the chorus for Watch It is short, and then the pre-chorus for Bad Luck is quite short, the creepy part is quite short, so I give both songs more than a pass, that's why 7-7. Alright, without further ado, let me go on to fifth track, Crying and Laughter, in 3, 2, 1. Okay, lower register. The instrumental very simple now. There's some like robot sound in the back. Oh, the pre-chorus! Yes, the track clip! Yes! Like the chorus so much. Wow. Laughter. Wow, the pause. Wow, the rap. In the second verse. Pre-chorus kicks in. The breathy second chorus. Yeah, the chorus is such a cooling melody and kind of sad melody. And then the post chorus with the la la las. Also kind of sad, kind of la la la. Oh, the breathy Yonghun voice with Sanu's rap. Wow. Wow. Now it's a slow instrumental. Clap together kind of moment. Last chorus! Yes! I like how they play with their voice! Wow, the high notes! The closing part. Alright, this song, I'll give it 10. Wow, there's nothing to don't like for this song for me, eh. Wow, the verses, the chorus, I really like how it flows. and it's very melodic. It's very my type of music. I like this vibe. I like how they sing the lyrics. I how they bring me through this song. So with that, 10 over 10. All right. Lastly, let's go on to Escape in 3, 2, 1. Okay. Firstly, hear the instrumentals. Jacob's voice? Q's voice? Eric voice. Slash Sanu voice. Hyunjae's voice. Wow, the pre-chorus. Oh, they're very breathy voices, and then the instrumental is very busy. Wow. It's total contrast. The instrumental is super busy with a lot of instrumentals. A lot of musical instrumentals. Alright, second verse. Wow. They sing with a lot of breathy technique. A lot of members are singing with this breathy technique. Wow. Wow, the beat, a lot of beats in the instrumentals. Okay, now it's lesser beats. It's more airy now. Alright, the chorus, the second chorus. Like bubbly sounds in the instrumentals. More bubbly sound continuing. Alright, the bridge come in. Just finger snapping sounds. Wow, breathy continuing the bridge. Alright, last chorus. With the breathy, not breathy, with the bubbly instrumentals. Okay, no high note for the last chorus. Is that it? Alright, that's the end. This is the other audio ready. Okay, with that, that is the end of Escape. I shall give it 8 because I think it's a very safe song. Throughout the song is very calm, very dreamy kind of instrumentals, and the way they sing it also very breathy, very calm, and it just sets the song in a very safe mode. So I won't be startled suddenly when listening to the song. It's just going to flow very nicely throughout and brings me to a wonderland, brings me to a dreamland. Yeah, so it's a safe song to me lah. Like anytime I listen to it, it won't make me feel annoyed. It will make me in a very peaceful mood. So I give it 8. The missing 2 points, I think, is because the instrumental I need some time to warm up to it, so I give it 8. All right, with that, I have done my first listen for all 6 tracks for this Sixth Sense comeback release of their second album, Fantasy. Let me now rank the songs up by looking at the scores I gave from first listen. All right, first place goes to Crying and Laughter, and then second place goes to Escape. Third place goes to Watch It and Bad Luck. They are the same score. Let me recall which song I would slightly put above. I think Watch It as my third, just slightly, not large margin, kind of above. Four, okay. Number four is Bad Luck. Number five is okay. Red and the Trap and Honey are the same scores. Oh no. Okay, I will make the hard choice. Number five goes to Honey, and number six goes to Red in the Trap. Okay. Why is that so? Because number one, no brainer, only one is the highest mark, which is Crying and Laughing. That's why it's number one. Number two, I give it to Escape because it's the second highest mark with 8. Number three, I give it to Watch It because I think I enjoy it slightly more than Bad Luck. So number three goes to Watch It. Number four is Bad Luck. Number five is Honey because I think I like the R&B part more. So number five is Honey. Number six is Rat in the Trap. Given that my first listen, I can't really recall any key moments. So yeah, that's my ranking for first listen from first track to sixth track. And thank you for listening to my MV reaction and first listen to Sixth Sense second album. And I shall see you in my next reaction. Bye bye.